Hey, horse people. Gonna do a, hang on, Mr. T. I know, you're a good boy. Come here. Gonna do a, buddy, don't be running off to the neighbors. You're gonna get in trouble. We're gonna do an injured horse. If a horse is injured, or you have a wild horse, I used to use this method to get people would adopt Mustangs. They'd leave the halter on, and when you buy a Mustang, they usually put a big halter on because they know people won't take the damn things off. Well, after a horse grows, I mean, I've taken halters off that have literally grown into the skin over a horse's nose because the people couldn't catch them, didn't know how to handle them, and they couldn't get the halters off. So there's a couple of ways to get a halter off a horse that you can't handle, and there's also, you can use this method if you have an injured horse and you need to either get him in a trailer or get close enough to doctor or touch a horse that normally wouldn't let you do it. Now, what promoted or prompted this video is someone wrote me, yeah, she's a woman. Someone wrote me and asked me, buddy, don't touch that camera. Buddy, I'm gonna beat you like a stepchild. You are in big trouble. You just come over and nose that, and now you're gonna get a beating. Knock it off. You're in big trouble. All right, let's try to set this thing up again. Crazy horses. Crazy horse. Hang on, Mr. T. I know. Buddy messed up the program. Now I gotta reset it. So I know where we're at. All right. We're still filming here. So, what this girl did, and she runs a rescue. I'm not going to say her name. She does good work. She made a mistake. Everybody does it. I've done it. Everybody's done it. Anybody that tells you ain't never made a mistake on a horse is lying, or they ain't handled many horses, or they ain't that damn good. Because every time you make a mistake, you learn, you get better. So, you can cry. You touch that camera again, you're going to get a knuckle sandwich. So, if you've got a horse that you can't handle, of course the wind's gonna pick up because I'm filming. It's okay, buddy, you can come say hi to me. You just can't touch the camera. Come on. He's looking all sad like he got in trouble. You did get in trouble. What this lady did, she had a horse with a hurt foot. So the horse is already wild. She don't know much about it. She may have heard rumors. I'm not trying to get the story specific. Basically, it was a bad move to try and trailer load a horse that's injured that you don't know. Now, if one of my guys was injured, I could probably trailer load them and feel pretty safe that they're not gonna hurt me. But when you start combining injury, pain, fear, trapping a horse in a trailer, forcing him into a small area, trying to do something you've never done with a horse before, and now you add pain and fear and trapping, look, it's not gonna turn out good. That's not a good move. So, I'm gonna show a little alternative here on how you could use this to either put a horse in a trailer or get a halter off a horse that you can't touch or you can't get close enough to, or doctor a wound on a horse that's too wild that you can't handle. So what I've done here, Mr. T, can you step back? Are you finished with that grass hay? Get that out of your mouth there. Are you finished with that? He's like, no, I was gonna snack on that later, Dad. All right, so what we have here, come here, Mr. T. This is a crude, rough area that basically I put, you can do this with three panels and a fence, three panels and a wall, or three panels and a horse trailer. Now, if I wanted to load a horse where this gate is right here, I would have a nice stock trailer that's big, open, that I'm not worried about. Sorry, mistake. That I'm not worried about. I'm not gonna try and load a horse that's scared of hurt in a slant load with a divider or a straight load with a divider, because that makes it too cramped. I want a big open area. If all I have is those, well then maybe I shouldn't load him, or I need to drug him up, or I need to call a vet out to him. But this is a scenario to where a horse is too wild and you can kind of get him. Most times if you get a horse, you can kind of corral him and move him. I mean, I've literally moved horses by putting hay out, having a bunch of people basically build, everybody brings two people, build a panel, and we basically build a round pen around a horse eating. and he lets us get this round pin pretty big, and then we slowly move each panel all the way around, and we move the entire round pin to where we want the horse, either to a gate or to where we need him. So there's a lot of ways to move or catch a horse, but normally you have to use something, food or something, to get him in a small enough area to where you can contain him. So as long as you can get a horse into an area, and in this situation the lady could have got him in this area because she led him up to the trailer before he ran her over and kicked her in the head or whatever it was. But if you can get him in this area to where there's just three panels, now I have a trailer that's open, so the only way for the horse to move is in that trailer. He can't move anywhere else. Now, this will work if it's done right, but like all things with horses, if you go too fast, you put too much pressure, you don't read the horse, you don't give release, and you try to do it quickly, then you get a horse panicking. This panel right here, most Mustang places, when you get a Mustang, they want the panels, I think, 6 or 7 feet. So they'd want a higher panel. The lower the panel, the more likelihood you can push a horse into trying to jump it. The higher the panel, the less likelihood a horse is going to try to jump it. So you're going to be able to put more pressure quicker on a high panel than on a lower panel. But the lower your panel, the less and slower you got to go. Now, slow is always better. Less is always more. You don't want to push this. If you got a horse rearing and trying to jump out, you're putting too much pressure. You're going too fast. This could take 5 minutes. It could take 3 hours. Okay? So I'm going to let Mr. T go in here, and then I'm going to show you how I would put pressure on him and move. And basically, I'm going to make this four panels smaller. I'm going to use this panel right here, and if there was two of us, we would do it. And we would basically move this panel inward. And the first move may be here. Second move may be here. Second one here. Second one here. Now I've got a horse in this small area. I may be able to reach in and do something that I need to do in this area. If I don't, I move the panel here. Let the horse move, kind of panic a little bit, move the panel here. Now the horse can't turn around. He's going to be backing up. He's going to have more pressure. I'm going to relax, back away, relax. He's got the small area. Then I may move the panel here to where I get him pinned between this wall right here, or panel, and this other panel. And now I can do what I need to do. So it's kind of a compression type thing. I'm just basically making my area smaller. If this was a trailer, I would do this moving. Pretty soon the horse would feel so trapped, he would run in the trailer to escape this small area, and I have him in a trailer without putting a human in there and try to pull. You get in a small area with a trailer, you start pulling and fighting with a horse, you're going to get trampled, kicked, etc. Next thing you know, you're going to have people saying that horse is dangerous, you should put him down, you shouldn't do it, you know, because you try to do something that you shouldn't do. When a horse kicks you, it's your fault, period. No ifs, ands, buts, coconuts, it's over. It's your fault, you did it. Had you not been there, you wouldn't have been kicked, period. So, I'm going to move Mr. T here, and I was going to take the halter off, and it doesn't matter, I'll throw it over his back. And Mr. T ain't got a clue what's going on. He's like, son of a, what the? So, I have this panel here. Mr. T's moving freely. I'm going to check and make sure that we're kind of zoomed in so you can see what's kind of going on here.
Mr. T's like, what the hell? He's talking at camera. This can't be good. All right, here we go. I'm going to start moving in on Mr. T. Now, when I'm moving in on Mr. T, let me check this camera one more time. Make sure you can see me at that front panel. Good.
You don't want some dummy moving the panel in like this, because a horse will kick through it. I want to be able to get some distance between me and this panel. If a horse kicks through it or bites, I want to be able to have some distance. So ideally, I would be better to have two people here. So, I'm going to unconnect this panel here. And you want to have two people also, because if you put too much pressure, a horse gets really panicky. He may try to run this panel over, and the last thing you want to do is drop this or let it fall. So, panel's off. And Mr. T's area, it's getting smaller. And he's like, dude, what's going on? I'm in a small area. Why are you doing this to me? Now, it's small because that gate is closed. If I had a trailer parked there that was open, he would be evaluating and moving, and I would still give him this release while I'm doing this. Let him figure it out. Let him go, why are you doing this? If it's a wild horse, when it's a wild horse, they'll be running. They may do a drive-by kick when they spin their circles. They're going to be backing up. They may put their butt to the fence. They're going to be doing all kind of shit to get you to stop to do this because they don't want to be trapped. So again, it may take time. Slow is better. I'm moving kind of quick because I know Mr. T. So I just shrunk his area more. Mr. T's like, dude, what are you doing? He can still turn. He just pushed the gate. If I let this gate fall or there's one person here, then I've ruined the whole thing and he learns how to get out. Now he'll rush every gate forever. So I do not want this gate falling. So, if you wanted to, you could back a car or a truck right into this so the gate couldn't come over. And you could have the truck moving back as you're lifting a little bit. To me, that's gonna be a lot more pressure. You're gonna have a truck backing up, exhaust. I mean, you can pull it in forward, just have it edged, so in case he does try to jump, it goes into the front of a truck with a grill or something. I think that's a lot more pressure. I wouldn't do that with a wild horse. I would do this slowly but surely. I'm gonna lose Mr. T's room a little bit more. Now he's kind of trapped where he can't turn around. So now he's gonna wanna go forward. He's looking for an escape. He's feeling trapped. This may be a point, if the horse calms down, for me to reach in and pet. Maybe touch a horse. A lot of horses will kick when you touch. Buddy, get out of there! Get! So, damn horse is gonna get in front of that camera no matter what I do unless I shoot his ass. You're gonna be horse meat. You're in big trouble. So, if I'm in here, this may be a good time if I had a stick. If I want to desensitize a wild horse, I could maybe reach in with a stick and rub and touch him, give him release. I don't want to poke him. I don't want to rub him really aggressively. I want to touch him and then back away. I want to touch him and back away so he learns that I'm not going to hurt him. So this is a way to desensitize a horse that's never been handled or touched. You can do this if a horse is in a trailer. If a horse is in a trailer, climb up there and reach through the window with a stick and brush him. Maybe with something soft and rub it on him. Maybe reach through and touch him. Maybe stand there, give him a carrot, offer him a carrot. When he's in a trailer and he can't move and can't escape that pressure, you can kind of get close to him. If you put too much pressure, he may kick your trailer, put a hoof through there, there's all kind of problems. If the horse fails, it's because you went too fast, period. I don't want somebody trying this, say, Rick, I tried it, and the horse jumped over the fence and broke his leg. You gave bad advice. Well, you're an idiot. All right, if you make the horse jump or panic, you went too fast. Like I said, this could take hours. I could move this a half inch and let this horse run around, panic, get scared, fright, panic, run circles, fart, piss, kick, do all this crap, and move another inch. And let him kick, piss, and do all that, okay? So I'm going to move a little bit quicker here because I want Mr. T to get this done. So now, Mr. T wants to back up. I've got this panel on this side. I've got the panel on that side. If I can get a horse like this to where he's calm and he's not panicking, I'm not trying to do anything, I could reach down, I could doctor a leg. If I had medicine, I could put medicine on his leg. If I need to check his heart rate, I could get something in here and be able to check his heart rate. If I wanted to get medicine on his back. Once you get a horse into this small of an area, now you can handle touch. If he had a halter on, I couldn't get it off. Now maybe I can reach up and take this halter off. Maybe I can get this unsnapped. Maybe I can, you know, help the horse. This is a situation where the horse needs your help and you've got to kind of put pressure that I normally wouldn't do, but if it's either this or nothing or getting your head kicked off because you tried to trailer loaded him, I'm gonna take this, okay? Getting my head kicked off is the last choice. Some people, they think it's the only choice and they try it, but you know, me getting my head kicked off. With this, I've got some distance. He can kick through the panel. He can't reach me. If he bites, I have two guys. If I let go, that guy over there is gonna hold it. If he lets go, I can hold it. We have enough pressure. So once you get the horse here, a lot of things change. I can desensitize, I can doctor, I can get the halter off. I can maybe even try to get him to give the pressure a little bit, head. I can start working with him a little bit to where I'm not fighting or being scared. Now, if, I'm gonna go ahead and lay this on Mr. T. So, poor Mr. T, you're such a good boy. All right, so I'm gonna move this back out to give Mr. T some release. I know, you're a good boy. I'm gonna give you a little release. So, Let me just put one of these panels in here. So now that I have the horse in that situation, let me check the time here. What am I at? 15. So now that I've got that done, I can doctor, touch. There's all kind of things I can do once I do this. Again, take your time. Maybe you want to just set up this four panel, let the horse sit in there overnight and feed him. And the next day, move it in a foot and feed him. Now, I don't leave a horse in a small area for a long time. If I'm going to do this, I want to do it to where I'm reading the horse and I'm seeing him. I'm giving him some release. I'm letting him know. I may move the panel back. Give him a little release. Say, hey, it's not going to hurt you. I'm going to come in and I'm going to come back. I'm going to come in a little closer and I'm not going to come back about quite as far. Again, not fast, rhythm, slow, not pushing or panicking a horse. That's how you get a horse that you can't handle, can't touch, and you need to doctor, get a halter on, do something to handle this horse in an emergency. Again, when a horse is hurt, in pain, feeling trapped and is scared, the likelihood of him reacting, because he goes into his fight or flight mode, he goes into his fear mode, he goes into his reaction mode, he goes into, hey, you're trying to kill me, I'm already hurt, I gotta be more aggressive because I'm hurt, I can't run. So I'm much quicker to go into my fight response because I can't run. My option to run has been taken away. You put him in a small area and now you've taken away his option to run even more. So you have to always be willing to understand pressure release. I'm working with a horse, I'm helping him understand. I'm not doing it to the horse, I'm doing it with him. You can come up here one of those panels, get five people and go, God damn, just push the panel in and pin that damn horse and push him against that wall, wire it up, hold him in there, by gosh, he'll learn. You can do that and it may work, but it's not ideal and it's not good. Now you may have to do that with some horse. If I try this and people are getting kicked and I can't do it and I gotta help the horse, then I may do it. Once I get close, I may be able to get in there to give him a shot, to give him a calming. I have a vet there, give him a shot to calm him down a little bit. I don't like giving shots for that reason, but you know, you may have to do it. So again, if I wanted a trailer load, the same method is I just put a trailer on one side. So my trailer, my open trailer with the door completely out of the way, the panels to the trailer door, that's my back wall. Then I have two side walls, and then I take this panel and I slowly force to where the horse has nowhere to go but in the hopefully the biggest stock open trailer you can get. Then once he goes in there, don't drop the panels, quick, shut the door, get a rope. If he runs in there, relax, maybe move in a little bit closer. Don't put pressure, let him chill out. I really don't want him coming back out, so I'd probably put the panel next to the door slowly so we can take the panels off and slowly get the door, slide the panel as we're shutting the door, and slide the panel away and in the doors there. So that's how you would get the horse in a trailer. Of course, Mr. T took a poop. So doctoring a horse, putting a halter on, for any reason that you have a horse that you can't handle. Now again, if you try this with a little foal and it's never been handled and it gets scared and you put too much pressure, it'll try to go through these bars, over them, kick them, do all kind of things. So you don't want to really push a little baby horse too hard that way. If you do, then you're going to end up with a jam. You may hurt the horse. You can hurt a big horse just as well also if you put too much pressure, hurt the horse, etc. So I mean, you can do it however you want to do it, but this is a way to get a horse. I don't see it used a lot. I've used it a lot. It seems to work pretty damn good. It's effective. I've gotten halters off horses that are growing in their faces. I've got them in trailers this way to where I could reach in. I don't know if you've ever seen, I've got a stick with a little hook and they sell them at a lot of these stores and they look more like a damn circus thing. It's got a point on this end and it's got a hook here. And it's good for hooking blankets or reaching in a place where a horse is at to where you can, it's an extension of your hand. And I've used that in a trailer when a horse is running around, I want to get that halter off. I would slide that in there and hook that hook right into that halter and it enabled me to get his head close enough so I could get that buckle, undo the buckle, and then I would just use that hook onto that hook and pull that, and that horse would pull the halter off, rip the skin out of his nose. It hurt him, but I had to get that halter off him. So, you know, different ways to do things. Hopefully that helps. I've talked about this in other videos. I've never really demonstrated or showed it. So when I got that email today about
the girl getting kicked in the head or stomped on or ran over or whatever you want to call it. it didn't turn out well. This would have been a better option, okay, to get a horse in a trailer or to move a horse when you've got to work with it. Again, this thing is so small. If you keep a horse in a small area, you know, he's not going to be able to get release. He's not going to be able to run from you. He's not going to be able to give himself release when you feed him, when you change his order, when you walk by there, sit next to him, read a book. He's going to get used to you being around. He's going to figure out that when you're around, bad things don't happen. So getting horses in small areas are good for a lot of reasons. I don't like keeping them this way all the time, and I definitely don't like keeping a horse that doesn't need this in a small area. But for a situation, for doctoring or loading or doing something like this, I think this is a good way to do it. It's a good way to get a horse used to people. It's a good training. I said, again, you've got to be able to get them to a small area. And if you get them in a big area, to get them in a small area is normally either food or pressure. Use a couple golf carts, a couple people on horses, a couple people in four wheels, whatever you got to do to get the horse to where you want him to go. Mr. T's relaxed. He got his little back leg there. He's like, shit, I'm in this damn cage. I don't know why. I might as well. All right, well, in that there, hopefully that helps. Let me chew on Buddy. Buddy, you're in big stink of trouble. You messed up this video twice, and now you're getting a beating. All right, well, in that there, Buddy, Mr. T, you're a good old boy.